Hi, it's Carly McAvoy. I'm talking today about properties of whole numbers. Some of these properties can be applied to real numbers, but the ones we're looking at today are specifically toward the whole numbers, which are counting numbers and zero. So the numbers you count with and zero make up whole numbers. The first one I want to talk about is the commutative property of addition in multiplication. So those are two different properties, one for addition and one for multiplication. In symbols, it just looks like A plus B equals B plus A, or A times B equals B times A. And you might wonder why we're using variables here instead of numbers, if it has to do with numbers, because we don't want to say it for a specific number set, like 2 plus 3 equals 3 plus 2. That's true, but by using variables or letters instead of numbers, we're suggesting that it's true for any numbers, any two different numbers. We don't have to say it's true for 2 and 3, it's also true for 7 and 5 and 9 and 12. We don't have to list everyone, we can just say in general that's the property. The way to remember this in words is that changing the order doesn't change the answer. So by changing from A to B, AB to BA, we change the order, but we don't change the answer. And you can think of that yourself. 2 times 3 is 6, the same way that 3 times 2 is 6. So that's the most fundamental one, the commutative property. The associative property, also there's one for addition and one for multiplication. For our purposes, I just combine those up because it saves a little space and time. But the associative property is when we change how things are grouped. Now, parentheses are grouping symbols. So if you look at the first half on the left, we have B and C grouped together. And if you look over here on the right, we have A and B grouped together, and C is no longer inside the parentheses like it was before. Notice that we did not change the order, A, B, C, A, B, C. That didn't change. If we change the order, then we're talking about the commutative property. But what we changed here was how things were grouped. Down below, we had B and C grouped together, and then we had A and B grouped together. So changing the grouping doesn't change the answer for addition or for multiplication. The next property is the additive identity, and that just says that when you add zero to a number, it doesn't change its value. And most of these things you're probably saying, yeah, no kidding, but we have to put names to them in order to talk about them correctly. So you can put zero at the beginning or the end. A plus zero is still A, or zero plus A is still A. So that's an important property that we use when we're solving equations and things like that. The multiplicative identity is when you multiply by 1. Doesn't matter if you put it at the beginning or the end. Anything times 1 is still itself. So multiplying a number by 1 does not change its value. Adding 0 to a number does not change its values. Those are the identity properties. But I listed them separately because they're 0 and 1 are different, so I wanted to show you that those are two different properties, but they have the same meaning. The multiplication property of 0 says if you multiply anything by 0, you get 0. And the distributive property is more complicated, and we'll spend more time on it later in the class. But for now, what it says is if you have a sum, like B plus C, you can multiply that by the term in front of it individually. So we could take A times B and get AB, and then A times C and get AC, and then add those together. You'll get the same answer as if you just left it in this process and did the parentheses first and then multiplied. This is going to become a really important property that we're going to use throughout the quarter. It happens for addition or subtraction. So in words, what I was just saying is you can multiply a sum or a difference being the subtraction one down here, by multiplying each term separately and then adding or subtracting the products, depending on whether you started with an addition or a subtraction in there. So that's the distributive property. So down here it says apply the suggested properties to write or simplify the following expressions, to rewrite, sorry. The commutative property. If I just ask you to use the commutative property and it's all addition, then we know we're talking about the commutative property of addition. What would that look like? Well, it could look like that I rewrite that as y plus, let me put that into an equation, I think that'd be better. y plus 5 plus 3. And then once I do that, I've reordered it. And then you could kind of see, well, if you have 5 plus 3, we could go ahead and simplify that because now we have the same terms there, both whole numbers, so we could say y plus 8. So that would be simplifying that by first rewriting it and then go ahead and combine those two terms. So there we go. Now the next one it says rewrite using the following suggested properties, and I'm suggesting that you use the associative and the identity. So associative property, we're just talking about how things are grouped. So in this case, what I'd want to do is think about, instead of having 3/5 outside the parentheses there, I'd want to have 3/5 grouped with 5/3. And then after I have those grouped, let me see what's the best way to do that. This way, times, trying to use the dots, times 5/3, and then have the y. So I use the associative property, that is regrouping those. But now when I regroup those, I could multiply those fractions, and you can see that the 3s and the 5s will both cancel out. And so that means that would equal 1y. And that 1y, the identity says multiplying something by 1, we don't even need to list that, so it would just be y. So we use the two properties there to do that. So that's how you could use more than one property and simplify that down to y. The distributive property, well, in the distributive property, we're going to want to multiply the first term 5 times x. And when you multiply a number times a variable, you just write those side by side. That means 5 times x. And then because we have a plus in the parentheses, we're going to put a plus here. And then we're going to multiply 5 times 7, which is 35. So we've just gotten rid of the parentheses by using the distributive property. And finally, what about this one? It says simplify using the identity property. Well, 0 is the additive identity, so I could just say that answer to 7 plus 0 is just 7, and that would be simplified as well. All right, so number 5, the property of 0, well, anything times 0 is 0. So b times 0 times n times 3 might look complicated, but I know that the multiplication property of 0 says if I multiply anything by 0, I'm going to get 0. So all I have to do is say that that is 0. Now on this one, I'm asking you for number 6 to use the commutative and associative properties. So I want you to rearrange it and regroup it. So there's more than one way I could do this, but what I probably would do was put the D out front and then have parentheses with MN. Now I've rearranged it, and I've also regrouped it because instead of M being with D, M is with N, and the D is in a different place, and so is the N. So I've rearranged it, and I've reassociated it too by changing the grouping. And you might have done something different, like make that NM and then put D at the front, or you could have just moved one of those. Number 7, also, if I'm asking you to use the identity property and there's just multiplication, the identity property says if you're multiplying by 1, you don't need to put that 1 there at all, so that would just be K. And then the distributive property, so notice over here what I could do is do inside the parentheses first using order of operations. 8 minus 5 is 3, and 3 times 3 is 9. That's totally true, but I can also do this. 3 times 8 is 24, and there's a minus in between there, and 3 times 5 is 15, and you then agree that 24 minus 15 is 9. So our answer is 9, whether we use a distributive property or we solve it the other way. And then finally, the last part is this, is saying which property or properties was used to rewrite the expression. Well, in this case, we had t plus 7 and we switched to 7 plus t. That's the commutative property, right? Because if we change the order, then we've used the commutative property. And what about the next one? Well, the next one says 17 times 0 is 0. That's the multiplication property of 0. That says multiplying something by 0 gives you 0. And then the next ones, we have a bunch of stuff in here. We have the 7 is moved, so we've definitely changed the order from the 7 to the front. So I know I could use the commutative. I'm just going to do that. Also, I had a 1 in front of the XY, but I didn't have it here. That's the identity. And finally, did I regroup anything? Not really. I still have XY in there, and I have XY. I did change the order, but changing the order is commutative property, and getting rid of that 1 is the identity property. And then finally, over here, what did I do? I regrouped. From 9 being grouped with 0, I grouped 9 with 8. So that's regrouping is the associative. And then I also said, but I added 0, but I didn't need the 0 on there, so that's the identity. So that's all the different properties that I used. All right, have a fantastic day, and I'll talk to you next time.